mistranslations of the King James Version. Bart D. Ehrman's book is just one of many exposing the mistranslations of the KJV. Behold, the deceitful pen of the scribes has made it into a lie. Jeremiah 8:8. There was only one way in which the adversary of mankind could successfully deceive the whole world, and this was accomplished through simple yet devious mistranslations which clearly contradict the original texts. Yahweh's foes didn't have to destroy every copy of the Bible, that would have been a little too obvious and quite difficult to pull off. However, tweaking a word or two here, or adding a verse or two there would be all that was needed to conjure false doctrines, confusion and ostracism by the church. Could mistranslations be the source for all the division we see today between denominations? Two Witness Ministries proves that this is why there is a great falling away in the last days. You deserve the truth. So finally, with our corrected NT translation, the New Covenant, Paleo Signature Edition, faithful disciples can come to unity in the last days and serve Yahweh. Satan who deceives the whole world. Revelation 12:9. Apostasy prophesied for our day. Let no man deceive you by any means. For that day shall not come, except there come a falling away first, and that man of lawlessness be revealed, the son of destruction. 2 Thessalonians 2:3. Falling away is the Greek word apostasia, means apostasy, defection, i.e. from the true religion. There are millions of believers in the Judeo-Christian Messiah and Savior of the world, yet there is little unity on what the Savior taught. How can so many be deceived in the latter days to cause this prophesied defection from the true religion? If the words of Scripture were mistranslated, then of course you will witness a great falling away. Such deception can only lead to destruction. Hosea 4:6, to avoid this curse, Yahweh gave a specific law to all Israel. We read this warning in Deuteronomy 4:2. You shall not add unto the word which I command you, nor shall you take away from it, that you may keep the commandments of Yahweh. You are about to see for yourself the overt mistranslations from the King James Bible version, as it compares to the oldest Greek texts. As a result, you will agree that the church has defected and certainly is not teaching obedience to the commandments as instructed by the Hebrew Savior and Messiah of Israel. Think not that I have come to destroy / annul the Torah law or the prophets, I have not come to destroy it but to fulfill, establish, it. Matthew 5:17. The spirit of lawlessness. For the mystery of iniquity is already at work. 2 Thessalonians 2:7. Iniquity here means deeds violating law and justice. Mistranslations by scribes are deeds of injustice against all mankind. Scholars admit to the numerous mistranslations within the New Testament of the King James Version. The two specific verses we will focus on will be those which portray the idea that the law has been done away, hence, a denial to observe the commands of the Torah law. The Torah law of Yahweh is not an option or a set of suggestions. Yet, that is exactly the teaching of Babylon's false prophets, including the coming son of perdition, i.e. the anti-Messiah, who will sit and rule the earth for the final 3½ years from a rebuilt Masonic temple. At the second resurrection, before the wicked are cast into hell fire, Hebrew Gehenna, all mankind will be judged for any and all lawlessness, as written in the Torah law of Yahweh. See Revelation 20. Because the carnal mind is resistant to the Torah law of Yahweh, Romans 8:7. Just because a person doesn't like the law of Yahweh or doesn't believe in an intelligent designer / creator doesn't mean they won't be subject to accountability. The prophets taught the Torah. To the Torah law and the prophets, if they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light in them. Isaiah 8:20. The prophets of Yahweh were exhausted seeing Israel straying from the commandments. This eventually resulted in Israel's slavery and captivity by Gentiles, including the Egyptians, the Philistines, the Assyrians, and the Babylonians. Therefore, the prophets calling the people to return in full repentance to Yahweh is the common theme found throughout Scripture, including the New Covenant writings of the apostles. Few listened then, and few listen today. Moses set the foundation with Yahweh's Torah law, reminding all mankind of the national blessings for obedience and national curses for disobedience. Leviticus 26, Deuteronomy 28, the psalmist wrote, Yahweh, I have hoped for thy salvation, and done thy commandments. PS.119, 166, the wisdom in Proverbs 7:2 reminds us, keep the commandments and live. And my Torah as the apple of thine eye. The prophet Jeremiah cried out long ago to us today. You struck them, but they felt no pain. They refused correction. They made their faces harder than stone and refused to repent. 5:3. The apostles taught the Torah. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but wanting to have their ears tickled, they will accumulate for themselves teachers in accordance to their own desires. 2 Timothy 4:3 NASB. There has only been one standard of righteousness for the righteous, the Torah covenant or marriage contract between the Almighty Creator of heaven and earth, Abba Yahweh, and His creation, mankind. A true believer is one who believes in this covenant, because only those who keep the every word of Yahweh will reap the benefit of the contract, which is the blessing of eternal life in His kingdom family. Blessed are they who do His commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life and may enter into the gates of the city, New Jerusalem. Revelation 22:14. Heaven is a conditional promise. Those who do not do His commandments do not have right to the tree of life. Yet, in contrast to this clear verse in Revelation, one of the Savior's last statements recorded for mankind, Christians are led to believe just the opposite, because of the fraud and deceit perpetrated upon them through their mistranslated English Bible, the King James, Pure, version. The apostles knew this and they never taught contrary to their Master and Messiah. Let's look at some additional Pauline verses which agree wholeheartedly with the Savior's final quote, but again, are ignored by false teachers of the Church of Babylon. But after thy hardness and impenitent heart treasurest up unto thyself wrath against the day of wrath and revelation of the righteous judgment of Yahweh, who will render to every man according to his deeds, to them who by patient continuance in well-doing seek for majesty and honor and immortality, eternal life, but unto them that are contentious, and do not obey his truth, but obey unrighteousness, indignation and wrath, tribulation and anguish, upon every soul of man that doeth evil, of the Jew first, and also of the Gentile, but majesty, honor, and peace, to every man that worketh good, to the Jew first, and also to the Gentile, for there is no respect of persons with Yahweh. For as many as have sinned outside the Torah law shall also perish without the law, and as many as have sinned within the Torah law shall be judged by the law, for not the hearers of the Torah are just before Yahweh, but the doers, Jew and Gentile, of the Torah law shall be justified, meaning, forgiven and receive His mercy. Romans 2:5-13. This is the same apostle whom the Church declares as having done away with the need to obey the Savior. This day of wrath spoken of here by the Apostle Shaul, erroneously called Paul, is not just the last day's great tribulation when civilization collapses under World War III, global famines and engineered biological plagues released by the New World Order upon an overpopulated planet, but this wrath, most importantly, includes the second death, the lake of fire Gehenna or soul extinction. And fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in Gehenna fire. Matthew 10:28. Let's remember what this most severe punishment of eternal death is for: unrepentant disobedience to the righteous, loving laws and commands of the Torah of Yahweh. Shaul was clear in Romans 7:12. Therefore the Torah is holy, Hebrew Kodesh, and the commandment, S, holy, just and good. Other apostles give such praise to the Torah law. Here are the words of the Messiah's close friend the apostle Yochanan, John, declaring what true love is. By this we know that we love the children of Yahweh, when we love Yahweh, and keep His commandments. For this is the love of Yahweh, that we keep His commandments, and His commandments are not burdensome. 1 J.5:2-3. That is the reason why all the apostles taught the Gentiles obedience to the Torah's commandments. Because breaking the commandments is sin. 1 John 3:4, The Savior's teachings were emphatic regarding how to please Yahweh for eternal life. If you want to enter eternal life, keep the commandments. Matt.19:17. The Savior's brother James, Hebrew Jacob, also taught the same message: be doers of the word commandments, James 1:22. Real faith leads to faithful obedience, Romans 6:16, because loyalty is judged by one's obedience. Disobedience through pride is why Lucifer fell to become the adversary, Hebrew Shatan or Satan, and disobedience is why Adam and wife Chua, Eve, fell from their original state in paradise, resulting in mankind's curse and the bondage of earth, read Romans 8:20-22. Messiah warns. Full well you reject the commandments of Yahweh that you may keep your own traditions. Mark 7:9. The apostles of Messiah observed and taught the seventh-day Shabbat, Acts 13:14-42-44, 18:4, Hebrews 4:8, as well as the annual feast days of Yahweh to those Gentiles being converted to Yahweh's way, 1 Cor 5:7-8, Col 2:16-17. They also refused the Talmudic traditions of the Pharisees. Besides his righteous calling to overcome the lusts of the carnal mind, disciples have to also understand that Satan's lies and deceptions have been sown into the word of Yahweh. As the prophet Jeremiah warned, the lying pen of the scribes, i.e. translators, would twist the words of Yahweh into falsehood, see Job 8:8, be not deceived. The church accepts mistranslations, turning Yahweh's mercy into licentiousness. Jude 4. King James I was a despicable pagan tyrant and homosexual who did not produce his 1611 version for satisfying the needs of the Protestant reformers of his day. King James I was not a Protestant at all. History records the persecution of Protestants by his great-aunt Queen Bloody Mary I, who murdered over 300 Protestants for their crime of questioning the sinful doctrines of the Anglican Church. Many, including the Puritans of the Plymouth Colony, fled from England because of this religious tyranny and oppression by pagan sun worshippers, including the King, James I. The pagan traditions of the Church continue to advance this spirit of iniquity, which. Long live Queen James. Michael B. Young's book, King James, and the History of Homosexuality. Christians foolishly attempt to justify based upon the following mistranslations found within 99% of all English New Testament versions of the Bible on earth. Sin cannot be justified, yet these blatant mistranslations within the 1611 KJV were made for that very purpose, to make acceptable the sins and lawlessness of King James I and those of his ilk. Man's devices have, in effect, turned Abba Yahweh's mercy, through Mashiach, into a license to sin or licentiousness. Jude 4, because the mistranslations are found in Shaul's writings, he is being blamed for teaching against the messianic doctrine of obedience. This apostle's writings were specifically targeted for mistranslation by the false scribes because his epistles were correcting the Gentiles in the Torah law of righteousness. 2 Tim 3:16-17, to perfect the growing number of disciples throughout the Roman Empire. The false scribes of Rome were anti-Semitic pagan sun worshippers, not of Hebrew lineage, and they did not accept the authority of the Torah. Remember, Shaul clearly stated, not the hearers of the Torah law are just before Yahweh, but the doers of Torah law will be justified. Romans 2:13, KJV. This is taken word for word from the Greek text. Such unmistakable words by the apostles contradict the grace teaching of the churches of Mystery Babylon. Now, behold the mistranslations. Galatians 3:10, KJV. For as many as are of the works of the law are under the curse, for it is written, cursed is every one that continueth not in all things which are written in the book of the law to do them. Did you spot the clear contradiction from the paraphrase as compared to the actual Torah quotation? Why would Shaul make a statement which places a curse upon those who keep the law, then use a verse from Torah which directly contradicts his claim? His quotation is taken from the Torah in Deuteronomy 27:26. Cursed be he that confirmeth not all the words of this Torah to do them. This word confirmeth in the Strong's Concordance Hebrew Dictionary is QOOM, meaning, stand with, maintain, establish, fulfill, ratify, to impose. Therefore, Deuteronomy 27:26 is better understood to say, Cursed be he who does not establish, fulfill, maintain, and impose all the words of this Torah to do them. Shaul is teaching the Torah to the Gentiles. Doing the laws and commandments of the Torah does not bring sin's curse. It's the falling away or departure from the Torah and hence not doing the Torah which brings the curse of death, Romans 6:23. So the question is, why does this verse in Galatians 3:10 contradict itself? Because the paraphrase in the first part of the verse is mistranslated. The KJV translation does not match the Greek. Here's the Greek text and notice which word was purposely not translated into the English. Galatians 3:10, Greek. Sigma omicron iota gamma rho xi rho gamma omega nu nu mu omicron upsilon epsilon sigma nu pi. As many for outside acts slash works of law are under. As. Kappa alpha tau rho alpha nu epsilon sigma nu, gamma gamma rho alpha pi tau alpha iota gamma rho tau iota. Curse slash execration are it has been written for. Pi iota kappa alpha tau rho alpha tau omicron pi omicron kappa mu mu nu epsilon iota. Accursed everyone who not remaining in. Pi sigma iota nu tau omicron gamma epsilon gamma rho alpha mu mu nu omicron iota nu tau. All the things have been written in the. Beta iota beta lambda tau omicron nu mu omicron upsilon tau omicron pi omicron iota sigma alpha alpha tau. Scroll the Torah law of the to do them. This literal translation of the Greek text does not agree with the English King James Version. As seen above, the Greek translation correctly reads. For as many as are outside the acts slash works of the Torah law are under the curse, as it is written. Accursed are those everyone who remain not in all things written in the scroll of the Torah law to do them. The Greek text is correct and agrees in theme with the actual quotation of Deuteronomy 27:26 from which it was taken. You saw the deliberate omission, in the KJV translation, of the most critical word, outside from Greek word, ek, the third word in this Greek verse. Why do Christian publishing houses around the world continue to perpetuate this glaring error? They have had hundreds of years to make this correction. Therefore, we have proof of a conspiracy by the Christian Church to keep people in the darkness of ignorance and sin. CEZ.22:25. Can you think of another reason? Galatians 3:10 was not the only verse that was purposely mistranslated. Behold a second witness to this conspiracy to alter the word of Yahweh and the message of righteousness for all peoples. Behold. Romans 3:20, KJV. Therefore by the deeds of the law there shall no flesh be justified in his sight, for by the law is the knowledge of sin. You are about to witness again the same omission of the word outside in this KJV verse as well. Romans 3:20, Greek. Delta iota tau iota xi rho gamma omega nu nu mu omicron upsilon omicron. Because that outside of works of the law no. Delta iota kappa alpha iota omega theta sigma epsilon tau alpha iota pi sigma alpha sigma rho xi nu pi iota omicron nu. Shall be justified all flesh in the sight of. Alpha tau omicron, delta iota gamma rho nu mu omicron upsilon pi gamma nu omega sigma iota. Of him through for the law, is, recognition. Mu alpha rho tau alpha. Of sin. The literal uncensored translation of the Greek reads. Because by doing works outside of the law there shall no flesh be justified in the sight of him, for through the law is the recognition of sin. These KJV mistranslations are the foundation for the church's doctrine of grace, which permits unrestrained sin breaking the commandments with the continuation of the pagan traditions and rituals of Baal, sun, worship. These distortions ignore other verses which clearly contradict the Savior's requirement to obey the every word of Yahweh, Matt 4:4. Luke 17:10. These mistranslations continue to be ignored by the Church of Babylon, which confirms the falling away in the last days. The Greek texts prove that the commands of Yahweh were not done away with, but the false teachers of grace don't care, beware. Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that does the will of my Abba who is in heaven. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, Have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name have cast out devils? And in thy name done many wonderful works? And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you, depart from me, ye that work iniquity. Iniquity here is grk anomos means, lawlessness. The Savior considers obedience more important than miracles. It is truly a miracle to find someone who will obey his word. Don't be surprised, there's going to be a lot of disappointed Christians as they will not be admitted into the kingdom of Yahweh. King Solomon wrote the following wisdom, saying, Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter, fear Yahweh, and keep his commandments. For this is the whole duty of man. Ecclesiastes 12:13. Do we make void the Torah through faith? Yahweh forbid, we establish the Torah. Romans 3:31. Only a remnant will be saved. Romans 9:27. The remnant of Yahweh. C/OPO Box 2453, Abilene, Texas 79604. 79604. 70.